it is important in cases such as Tejpal case and the Arushi Talwar case that people know what is being done and how, what the police is doing, what evidences they are gathering. But this should be a delicate balance between not obstructing the course of justice, but there should be a balance. And if the media don't take a stand, then I don't think those kind of issues could be brought into the main public debate. So I think it is important for the media to take a stand.
The media, I think, has a very prominent role, covering these kind of issues, because if the media doesn't do it, who else will do it? I mean, how will the public come to know about something like this happening? So I think media has a very prominent role in it. And only thing that we have to think about is, like, you know, how much of privacy that we are giving to the person who's been affected. When you go ahead and go tell the name of the person or reveal the identity of the person, obviously they're going to be having a lot of side effects and impact on the life of the person that you've got. So as a whole, the media should go focus on all these kind of issues, but at the same time, see to that they maintain the privacy and, you know, have a proper norm, like the ethics that they follow has to be followed. Otherwise, media has a very prominent role and it has to be.
But in one particular case is aligned towards somebody or some idea, it doesn't mean that media should be focusing on or giving more weightage to that side of the coverage. They should try to give a balanced view. But in some cases, if you have, say, 5 or 6 facts about the case and 5 of the facts point to one particular person, that there are more chances that this person has committed the crime or he is at fault or this is the issue in that particular case, then there is nothing wrong in highlighting that, because that is where the facts point out. But otherwise, the media cannot take a stand just because the public sentiment is towards that.